I'm expecting this to be a little bit more strain on the powertrain than the battery. Which all this stuff has been.
I don't know.
Or the battery. Hit it with 1,200, 1,500 amps for a minute or two straight.
That's
going to hurt everything.
That'll be a really good challenge. Better us than the customers.
True.
We have to do everything our customers are going to do, and our customers are going to send it.
We can do it.
All right, we're rolling. Okay, we are at 2,000 feet.
Yeah, right there.
We're doing the Davis Dam cycle, and so this is where a lot of trucking companies come to prove out their towing capacity. What we're really looking for is maintain cabin temperature and then maintaining the powertrain cooling as well. And what we're trying to get is a limitation in neither.
Did it on Davis Dam with 11,000 pounds, so it was pretty good to see that, like, thermal validations happening. We were passing all the criteria, so felt pretty great. All those 36 hours is definitely all worth it. The team that I work with, like, everybody's so passionate about everything they do. Everybody wants to just work on it, get it done, and get it done in the right way. Even if it takes 24 hours, 36 hours, we'll get it done the right way.
My parents back in India, like, they have been so impressed with the product. My father is also in automotives. He's so excited about this product, like, it'd be cool to show him what I work on.
Yeah, target is to charge at least up to 440 for tomorrow's testing. People are going to love this truck once they just get their hands on it.
Today, we're at Mount Charleston doing some uphill testing in extreme heat and testing the thermal system. So today's goal is for completely hands-off. It's like a customer would be in this vehicle and they could drive it up and have no intervention. Realistically, if we have customers that own our vehicles, that live out here, or want to drive around here and see the scenery, we need to build a car for them too. So we're really testing the car so that our end users can use the truck the way they want them.
Like, it's 99 degrees Fahrenheit, and we're already at 4,000 feet. This is a fairly extreme test. It's a step up in difficulty from what we were doing in Davis Dam.
Targeting 50 mph.
Copy that. We're at 35 right now, and increasing speed.
Cruising, you know? The car seems to be performing really well. Temperatures are okay. Haul's perfectly fine.
We gathered lots of data today, so I'm excited for tomorrow. Go for tomorrow's Death Valley, which is like a much harder grade. So if you're able to pull that on that, this should be an easy one.
What we're going to do today is go run another step up in severity for our usage cases, like we talked about yesterday, on some of the other higher hills, high grades, long duration. Conditions are so severe with the grade, the weight, the temperatures, and the reason we run it is because it's kind of a final check to quantify how good or how robust our cooling systems are. We take the vehicles out. We run them in real-world conditions. We capture everything we can possibly think of to help correlate our lab work.
SOC.
They're looking good so far.
Okay,
can you make it 8600 and open the EXP to around 350?
Done.
I was like hoping,
it's
go.
We
got a golden data set today. We tried to push the system to the limits and see like how it behaves, like how the customer will actually see the vehicle behave.
I'm trying to mode up here so that we can take this car out and do another run of Town Pass in Death Valley.
All right, let's go to ride height. Let's go to design height. We got, do we check trailer lights, Matt?
Yeah, do yours plugged in. You can brake lights.
All right, we're rolling.
This is most like, but a race team of friends that, you know, everybody's aligned towards the same goal.
All right, we are at 55.0 mph. Maintain.
Okay, we are at around 3,000 feet. The motor temperatures are rear at 83, front at 96. Battery cell temperature max is 44. The discharge light pressure is 1768. We're gonna pull over.
Copy that.
It went well.
Yeah.
Really well. This whole trip has been so wonderful. Yeah, we learned a lot, I think.
And if he's happy, I'm happy.
Yep.
Things we hadn't ever seen before that don't show up until you go out in the real world and try them out. And really having the team work so well together. That's the amazing part. That's the special part about working with these guys. Carry on, get the work done and finish the mission. That's the next thing. We got more trucks to build.